So are you aware of when, at what point, you kind of figured out the kind of music that you wanted to make, the kind of jazz music you wanted to make? And was it at all challenging for you at any point, kind of getting to that landing place where you're like, this is what I sound like when I write music, because you're a phenomenal songwriter and composer. This is the kind of music that I write and compose. And this is now my identity as a jazz musician. This is the kind of jazz I make.
Yes. So there was a definite sort of a circa, like it was around about when I was about, I must have been about 21, 22, and it was towards the end of my jazz degree that I knew the kind of jazz that I wanted to record. Now, remember, at this point in time, I'd been listening to a lot of Miriam Makeba. I'd been listening to a lot of Sibongile Khumalo, who was kind of this bridge between classical and jazz, right? So I used albums like Sibongile Khumalo's Live at the Market Theatre, right, where she sings, you know, also she sings Bacon Selig with, you know, repertoire on there. You know, she sings, you know, Moses Moleleko's repertoire on there and Abdullah Ibrahim's repertoire on there. And so I knew that there was this rich South African jazz tradition that I wanted to be a part of. And here's Miriam Makeba singing kind of folk African music, right? But also with an aesthetic that was in a way global. I don't even know if that makes any sense at all. And maybe that aesthetic was created by some of the instrumentation on her albums, because there were times obviously where she would be accompanied by very minimalistic, you know, instrumentation. And then she also had albums that were sort of very arranged, right? So I was listening to this and I was listening to, what is my language? What does Xhosa sound like, you know, over a jazz progression, right? What is the click of my language sound like? What is the lyric, what is of vernacular sound like against the backdrop of this particular sound? Because I've been studying Ella Fitzgerald, you know, you study the songbook, the American Jazz Songbook, right? And it's English. And then you study, you know, Latin American, and you study Bossa Nova, you're singing Portuguese. Well, you think you're singing Portuguese until you actually hear and things like that. Like, well, maybe that one, you know, but either way, we were trying, right? We were faking it till we make it. And so I thought, you know, I always knew that I wanted my music to speak to who I was. And I think these women and these artists whom I've named were for me good examples of what my music could sound like. And I knew that I wanted to write in Xhosa because I wanted my music to be rooted in my identity. And when I started to write music, I didn't really kind of, there was no sort of crazy method of, it must be this, or it has to be 6/8, or the groove must be African, or it must have this bass drum thing, and it must, you know, I just wrote, you know, I really just wrote. And maybe it came from a place of subconsciously having absorbed all the music that I'd been listening to. And then when I started to write, you know, little bits and pieces of all this music that I'd listened to were coming together. You know, and I remember lamenting to a former teacher of mine, Natasha Roth, whom you know well, right, when I used to go to lessons with her, and I'd be like, how do you write songs? Like, I don't write songs, and I feel like I'm weak, or I lack, and I can't get booked for gigs where, you know, where venues want original music, because I don't write original music. And she said the most amazing thing to me, and she said, to be a great musician and to be a great artist and singer, you don't have to write your own songs. You know, she was like, there's such deep artistry in interpreting songs that already exist. You know, and she said, so maybe focus your energy on that and really growing your craft, you know, through the practice of interpretation and delivery, right? And nuance. And when you've got something to say, and as you get older, you might find that you'll start to write songs, but don't push it, you know? And that's why I only started to write music after I'd graduated my master's already. I mean, it was a while after studying that I started to write, you know, and I'm happy I did that. I think I needed that assurance that says you'll find yourself and your music will mimic who you are and your music will be your identity. But if you force it, you're going to lose the plot.